Good day, everyone. Time for the tropical update with J7409 on Sunday, the 5th of August, 2018. We're looking at Hector here, Hurricane Hector. Now, we're going to check in with the National Hurricane Center in a few moments. I've seen reports from all over in different models saying different things about Hector this morning. Some have it at a Category 3. I think with winds of 125. Some have earlier this morning downgraded it with winds of 105. We'll check in with the National Hurricane Center and see what their latest report is. But this is what Hurricane Hector looks like right now. It's a fairly small hurricane in size. It's got a good punch with it, though, and you can see the eye well deformed. So this is Hector. Now, this is a picture of Invest 97 out in the Atlantic. Okay, you can see how messed up it is. It's not well deformed in any way right now. It's not well formed in any way. However, it could get some characteristics coming up. We'll keep our eyes on it, but as of now, I don't think it's going to bother the U.S. at all. Doesn't look like it. Like yesterday I was talking, it may go over in the France area, maybe up into Ireland. The UK should get some rain from it also. But as of right now you got to remember, all of this stuff can change, as you guys know. But as of right now, that's what it's looking like to me. Now, at the moment, it does have 30 knot winds that are around it, and the minimum central pressure in Invest 97 is 1010 millibars. Now we have a whole bunch of models here, and my favorite, of course, is the black line. That is the TVCM model. It is pretty doggone accurate because it compiles all the others together. And it still has Hector not making a direct hit on Hawaii or the Big Island. However, of course, this cone of uncertainty will go over the Big Island, but it's looking like, so far as a direct hit right now, that's not looking like it's going to happen. Looks like it's probably, my estimate would be anywhere from 60 to 100 miles away from the island. That doesn't mean that parts of the island will not receive rain or some wind, because they will. Okay, but it's not going to be the full brunt of Hurricane Hector by no means. It's looking like, let's see, right around in here, if this will come up right quick. Here we go. Come on and load up. Okay, on the 8th, I believe that's Wednesday, the winds will be 110 in Hector around 2 a.m. in the morning. And we'll move up one more little notch here when it is going past the island. And what shall it be? Come on, load up, load up, load up. Here we go. See, it's going to die down 105 miles per hour. And this is like Thursday morning at 2 a.m. You know, I've watched some of these comments and stuff, and I don't understand some people. Some people act like they get upset if a hurricane don't hit somewhere. Come on, people. We don't want this hurricane to hit Hawaii. And it doesn't look like it's going to make a direct hit. So that's a good thing. We should be happy. All right. Now, let's go ahead and check on the TVCM model what's going on over in the Atlantic with Invest 97. As of this morning, right in here, here is Invest 97. Not that many models on it. I hadn't formed enough to do much of anything yet. But I do think that chance is still there, okay? And the black line has it coming up, as you can see. We do have the Canadian model, and we also have the, let's see if we can get it to light it up so you guys can see yourself. This is the forecast pattern for it on the Canadian model, Invest 97L. And it's got it coming over to France. How about that? But I think as it progresses along, it may nudge a little further north. I don't know for sure yet. We'll have to wait and see. This is just this particular model putting these two scenarios together and showing the projection. I do not think it will be a big bad hurricane when it comes in over this way. I think you guys, more or less from Ireland, the UK, and France, you are going to get rain, rain, rain. Now, as we take a look at Hector, this is Hector right here. This is the Congo line going on. I'll talk about that in a moment, but right now let's concentrate on Hector. Here's a big island of Hawaii and all the rest of the little islands. This is at 10 a.m. this morning. We're going to move it up to around 5 p.m. this afternoon. We can see how Hector is moving to the north-northwest. We'll go to 11 p.m. this evening. Kind of hanging around, not doing too much. 7 a.m. tomorrow morning. Hector starts to move again, but it looks like it's taking a little dive more westerly. And at 2 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, this is what it's looking like. Let's move up to around the 8th of August. Here we go, when Hector is beginning to get closer to Hawaii. You can see the eye and the main severity of the storm right now. This is at 10 a.m. on Wednesday, is well south of the Big Island. However, some of these winds and rain will be hitting this island. Let me see if I can make this a little bit bigger for everybody. And we want to move it over some so we can see a little better. Here we go. What about the wind, sustained winds? Not bad at all. They're not even hitting the Big Island very much at all. The green is wind, of course, which is hitting everything, and that's looking like that's 20 miles per hour. So, and this is with the European model, okay? This is a very reliable model. We'll check out the wind gust. Now, we do have a little bit of some more heavier, or stronger, I should say, wind gusts that may affect some of the northern part of the island. That's 35 miles per hour. But of course, as you can see, down closer to the center and to the eye of Hector, these wind gusts are 109 miles per hour. That should not affect you right now. So we've got this all blowed up. We're going to go back to just rain. You can see what it's looking like. This once again is the European model at around 10 a.m. on Wednesday the 8th. We will move it up to around midnight. You can see it already has passed. It's right south. The main brunt of this storm should not hit as of now unless something changes. Rain, of course, on the Big Island, rain all the way up to Honolulu, rain on all these islands at some point from all of these rain bands. What about the wind? Sustained wind. All right, we've already been through this. The main heavy wind, strong high winds are going to stay below. The other winds of 20 to 30, who knows, you might get a 40 mile per hour gust once in a while. They should be what is affecting. But lots of beach erosion, okay? Lots of beach erosion, all that stuff that goes with it, the rain. You might have some water standing around, you know, you will in places. As far as wind gusts for this time, this is what they're looking like. Right down here at the tip, this is looking like 31 mile per hour wind gusts. We'll get up in the darker areas, which this is all water in between the islands. What's going on up here? That's 38. You can't see it, but trust me, that's what it's saying right there. So that's what that's looking like. Now, to finish up what this looks like on the European model with Hector, we will go up to around 12 p.m. on Thursday the 9th. Hector should be clearing out, just a few rain showers left around the Hawaii area. So now, of course, we're over to the National Hurricane Center, and we are going to check out what is going on, as they call it, disturbance number one. This is still a non-tropical low pressure system as of 7:33 this morning. It's centered about 1,000 miles west southwest of the Azores. It continues to produce limited shower activity. We could see that by the picture I showed you. It is like sprawled out everywhere. It's not organized at all. Environmental conditions are expected, though, to become marginally conducive for the low to acquire subtropical or tropical characteristics while it moves little over the next day or so. It's just going to stay right where it's at. The water there is around 80 to 83 degrees. It's going to stay there. And yes, there is a good chance of it forming into something. Not a high chance, but a good chance. Now, it's not going to move much over the next day or so, but when it does, it will start to move northeastward through Tuesday, okay? And that's when I say it's going to move northeastward. We plotted it out a while ago, looking like maybe France, looking like maybe Ireland. No matter what it does, though, it's going to get in cooler waters. You guys water up around that area now. Is anywhere from 70 to 75 degrees, so it will downgrade from whatever it is. But everyone up in those areas, I'm going to go ahead and tell you, get right for rain, because rain will be headed your way. Now, in 2 days, it has a 30% chance of forming. In 5 days, a 40% chance of forming. And this is what it's looking like on the 5-day map from the National Hurricane Center. That's still at 40%. Now, as we turn over to the Pacific, here's the Congo line. As we saw on the other maps, let's check out Hector first. As of 2 a.m. this morning, it was a Category 3. The winds were 125 miles per hour or 110 knots. I think those knots have come down just a little. They may not have, okay? I haven't done all the calculations for the models yet, but it looked like maybe, but I doubt it. It's probably still 125 miles per hour with a minimum central pressure of 957 millibars. If you're tracking Hector, 14.4 north, 135.7 west, and Hector is moving at a good pace. That's a good thing. West at 12 miles per hour. Now, as we come over here, this is disturbance number one. These showers and thunderstorms are associated with an elongated area of low pressure about 900 miles southwest of the southern tip of the Baja California Peninsula. And it's changed little in organization overnight. It's just like it was, more or less. And a tropical depression is expected to form within the next day or two while this system is moving very slowly westward. Now, it looks like it's on the same track of Hector almost, huh? In 2 days, it's got a 70% chance. 5 days, 90% chance of forming. And I do think it will form, okay? Over here we go to disturbance number two. Satellite imagery indicates that showers and thunderstorms associated with this area of low pressure, which is located about 400 miles southwest of Acapulco, Mexico, have become a little better organized overnight. The environmental conditions are expected to remain conducive for additional development, and a tropical depression is likely to form later today or tonight while the system moves west-northwestward off the coast of Mexico. 2 days, 90%. 5 days, 100%. Now we come to 11E. Now, 11E is a tropical depression now. It has winds of 35 miles per hour. The minimum central pressure, 1,006 millibars, located 13.0 north, 96.9 west. Movement, west-northwest, they're all in the same pattern. It's moving at 12 miles per hour. And here's the tracking map from the National Hurricane Center for Hector. As you can see, Hector is a major hurricane, should remain a major hurricane through tomorrow, but by Tuesday night, Hector should start to decrease in strength and become a Category 2 hurricane. And as it moves on out of Category 1, it's just going to keep weakening. The cone of uncertainty here, just barely on the very southern tip of the Big Island of Hawaii, but for the most part, it's looking just like all the other maps I showed you and what I was telling you. It should miss and not have a direct impact. The wind map shows it a whole lot better than I can explain it to you folks. This is the tropical storm force wind speed probabilities of any of these islands having severe winds of tropical storm force. I'm going to go through it all for you, okay? As you can see, this was made last evening and it runs through August 9th. Well, 8th and 9th, it's going to be moving on up. This is what it's looking like for tropical storm winds affecting any of the islands of Hawaii. The darker green, you have a 5% chance, as you can see right here. The lighter green, 10, I believe the highest you have. Maybe the very tip will get tropical wind speeds. That's 50%, then it moves up to 40%. So this is for the tropical winds. Let's check out hurricane winds. Here we go. The hurricane force wind speed probabilities made last night runs through August the 9th. This is what it's looking like. All of the Big Island only has a 5% chance of receiving any hurricane strength wind. Now, the outer banding features of Hector have become less evident since the previous advisory. With Hector moving into an increasingly drier air mass, the chances of Hector evolving into a annular hurricane are increasing in the longer term. Although the hurricane will be embedded with a light vertical wind shear environment, marginal SSTs and much drier air mass characterized by the mid-level humidity value less than 40% are expected to produce a slow weakening trend throughout the forecast period. Now, the official intensity forecast is a little lower than the previous advisory and closely follows the intensity consensus models of the HCCA, the FSSE, and my favorite, the IBCN, which all show steady weakening. While the official forecast track continues to lie south of the Hawaiian Islands, it is too soon to determine what kind of impacts might occur in the state. Now, since the track errors can be large at long time ranges, now this remains a good time for everyone in the Hawaii Islands to ensure they have their hurricane plan in place. Okay, now as we look down at the bottom, you can see the intensity 125 so far as the winds, 12 hours, 125, 24 hours. Tomorrow, the wind should drop down to around 120 and then 120 in 36 hours, 48 hours, 2 days from now, 115, and then it just keeps dropping down to 100 in 120 hours. I believe the way that I have calculated some of the stuff that I haven't had a chance to do everything this morning. I think it should miss Hawaii, like I said earlier, anywhere from 60 to 100 miles out of making a direct hit on the Big Island. We'll have to wait and see. This stuff is so tedious and it can change at any time. But that's a tropical update for today. Thank you so much for watching. If you haven't subscribed, please do subscribe. Click the bell to make sure you get all the latest and tropical news information, okay? Thank you for everything you do. May you have a good day, a blessed day, and peace, love, and kindness to each of you.